morning, everyone. I'm very happy to have you here. I'm one of the presidents here at Otterbein, and we're really excited to have some speakers here today for Otterbein's pop-up Kindness Think Tank. I want to thank you all for your participation and your support of this effort. I'm really glad to see some of the students and staff, also community leaders here, as well as new friends to help us get this started. So today is National Make a Difference Day. So in addition to this tank, this think tank, Otterbein students are also hosting a 100 Euros 5K to raise funds for food insecurity. And they're also hosting a fall harvest festival to offer friendship, food, and fun to the Otterbein community and to our local neighbors. I want you to know that what you're doing here today by taking time out of your schedules to think about how to cultivate kindness also participates in you have campus and community leaders here who care about what you think and they want to hear your ideas today. At Otterbein, we believe that every new idea has the potential to become a great idea. Otterbein also believes in the spirit of kindness so much so that we talk about it being part of our DNA. Kindness at Otterbein is about knowledge, compassion, a genuine regard for others, and a commitment to advance a greater public good. That's why we're proud to be a lead educational partner with the Kind Alliance Initiative at the Columbus Foundation. So we're partnering with us and we're very proud to have them as part. This effort is about finding ways to cultivate and inspire kindness. We want folks to make it a habit. And we want to find ways to encourage others to join in practicing kindness, much as you will be doing this morning. At Otterbein, we're calling this our Kindness Matters Initiative. And when you leave today, give you some materials that explain this in more detail and talk about how we're going to be. So speaking of kindness, we have some great sponsors and partners who have helped us make this program possible today. We want to say thank you to them for their support. So I'll start by saying thank you to April Schad. She's been a state farm insurance agent for 27 years here in Westerville, and she values working with her team to help families know that they are protected. April couldn't be here today, but she sends her greetings and wanted you to know how proud she is to be helping make today's think tank possible, as well as supporting our Kindness Matters Initiative. She's also doing great work with Mayor Bacuzzi's Neighbor to Neighbor effort, and you'll hear more about that later this morning. April also provided the bags for the kindness gifts that you'll get at the end of the day, so I thank April for great support and what she's doing for her community and for kindness. We'd also like to thank our other sponsor, Jasper, for medical equipment. They're here this morning in full support with an impressive group of their leadership team for the company. Not only do we appreciate Vasco's generous support of this event and their success as a family-owned business headquartered right here in Westerville, but we're also proud that all three of the leaders for this morning are on my alumni. I hear that they're hiring a few more cardinals as well. So with us today is Dan Gifford, Dan, who can give away CFO at Vasco. 1988 Otterbein accounting alumnus. Jason Seeley, president of Vasco and MBA graduate from 2006. So we're happy to have Jason here as well. And finally, his sister Rachel Seeley Monser, CEO of Vasco and MBA alumnus of 2010. So, Rachel, do you want to come forward and see you?
Sure.
Can you guys come in?
So we took our logo and we actually parted it to remind us of how important the service is.
And as I was thinking, as I saw the email, I said, hey, why is service important to you and your team? I started thinking about it, and it was kind of selfishly, it makes me happy. I think it makes our team happy. It gives us an opportunity to make a difference. And at the end of the day, I believe it produces results. And so that's why it's part of our culture. It feels good and it works. So it's nice to be here. This is it.
Yeah, and as we, you know, as I look at, you know, being a part of the team at NASCO, it's truly embedded in the culture. It's kindness, it's happiness, it's, you know, I've worked in environments where people aren't real kind and people aren't real happy. It's a pretty easy correlation to make. And so being blessed to, you know, through another Otterbein alumnus, Kevin Bannon, who I worked with in another job, he recruited me to come work with Jason and Rachel. And he's like, this is a blast. We have fun every day. I can tell when Rachel or Jason are in the building because you can hear them. And you can hear the entire floor, and everybody else gets, you know, a little bit of an uptick from it, and it's just infectious. And I love to see what's going on at Otterbein and the kindness initiative and how that can spread through the community and just make us, you know, a happier, you know, more engaged community. Because there's so much that's dragging people down and higher than you put in my life.
And so to something Jason and I came to an epiphany, geez, probably about 5 years ago, where we're talking about someday, when we have time on our hands, we're gonna make a difference in this world. And what hit us with this epiphany was we have 250 associates on our team. We service 42,000 patients every single month. Like, if we're ever going to make a difference and change the world, it's going to be through NASCO. This is our legacy. So that's why it's part of our culture. We ask all of our associates every quarter, how kind are we being to our patients? How are we doing our referrals? How are we treating each other? And we gauge it, and we do initiatives. And as we grow, things change. We have to, you know, repoint the ship in different directions. But I do believe, like Dan said, you come into the company, we're so lucky that the people at NASCO embody the value of kindness.
Providing the education for the future of our societies and having that kind of impact on the society.
Dan Petruzzi is working to grow kindness in Westerville neighborhoods through an effort called Neighbor to Neighbor. So I'd like to ask Dan Petruzzi to come forward and welcome the group and say a few words about what she's up to. So.
Yeah, what are you up to?
He's busy, wait.
I stopped in the store. I hope you know good. We're definitely a Harry Potter family in that house. So.
Hi, everybody. I want to thank you all for coming out on this beautiful day. Here means that kindness is important to you. You either want to learn more about it, you want to be kinder, you want to have other people be kind to you. So that's what today's all about, learning about kindness and how we can better ourselves. So if people come into my group, I'll tell you more about their origin and neighbor to neighbor, but I'll give you the basics. About a year ago at this time, I was observing a mayor's court session and I saw our zoning officer. And I asked him why he was there, and there was a couple people that he had to take to court for not keeping up whatever zoning initiative it was. So we started talking about how can we keep people from getting to this point? How can we keep them in their homes and their houses upkeep and their lawn mowed? And we started talking about, well, the person, the neighbor that called in this complaint, because all our issues are usually unheard of. So someone people, the neighbors, know this person. Do they know that they're not cutting their grass because maybe they broke their leg or had some kind of injury and couldn't do it? Do they know they're not painting their house because they lost their job and have to provide food on the table instead and not priorities? Whereas if you know your neighbors, and that's not only the people next door to you, it's the big neighbor in the whole sense of the word, but you can start in your neighborhood. If you know them, then you understand them and you can help them. And what a better place it would be, I think, if we're all kinder to those who we associate with every day and those we meet. So this started the conversation and we started asking more people. Ironically, there were a lot of people who were thinking the same thing. That's where the kindness initiative started coming in. Met with Dr. Krendl and we're at the same point, talking about kindness initiatives. Met with Rick Bannister, who has established neighborhood bridges. And they're all part of the neighbor-to-neighbor initiative. The initiative that we have is not a 501c3 organization. It is a way to promote kindness throughout the city and community of Westerville so that people will get to learn more about what it is to be kind and how to help people. Because kindness, everybody likes being the recipient of kindness. Everybody likes when someone says something or does something nice for them. But as Jason said, it makes you feel good when you do an act of kindness as well. Then on the third point of that is, you never know where that act of kindness is going to lead. You don't know how it's going to affect the person, the organization, or whoever you do this act of kindness, or you never know. And it may come the next day, it may come the next week, or maybe a year from now, and you'll see that it's gone even farther. So I think the kindness is the thing we all need to practice more, and hopefully by the end of the day, we'll have some more ways to get people involved in kindness. We have five great kindness topics today, and you get to choose to join in on at least three of them. All are great choices, so I know you'll be inspired and get involved in the engaged in this process. My thanks to the leaders who will help lead the discussions today, including Mayor Cruzzi, Drs. Carla Corroto, and Sandy Scotland, as well as Rick Bannister and Rick. So if you want to give a wave. As Kathy mentioned, he is the head of Neighborhood Bridges, which is again doing wonderful things for our community and really taking off in terms of the support that it offers. I want to chat with Judy Guy and Huxler. Do you want to give a wave?
Oh.
Okay. And our interim provost, Dr. Wendy Sherman Heckler. So Wendy's here as well. So, and Carla and Sandy, always. Okay. So to get us in a good mindset, I'm pleased to introduce you to our vice chair and associate professor of sociology for criminology and justice. Carla is also heading up a research effort that is part of our partnership with the Columbus Foundation around the research initiative into the concept of kindness. She will be partnering with a team of researchers to explore what we understand about kindness, how we might better cultivate kindness, and what it might take to make it a habit, that is to develop that muscle.
reaction to a situation is an automatic response that comes. That's what we're trying to build here. So my thanks again to all of you for joining us today. I'm counting on all of you to put your minds to the kindness and best use today. The world needs what you have to offer. So thank you for being here and part of it.
Perfect. Krendl, very much. To get started today, everyone has a white note card on their table. I want you to, just to start. Okay. I want you to think about kindness and distill your thoughts into one six-word sentence, and please write it on that card. Does anybody need a card or a pen? Guys, we've got something to write in. What would you like? Yes. Think about kindness. Distill your thoughts into one six-word sentence. Six words. And you'll need two hands to count. This isn't easy at all. And I don't expect it to be easy for us to do. It'll take a second. Just help if I stop talking.
Can you face each other?
and balance on the balls of your feet, and close your eyes, but don't do it yet. Here's the rules. I'm going to tap you once, and I just want you to tap your knees. If you get tapped once, just tap your knees. If I tap you twice, stand up, but don't open your eyes. If I tap you three times, do whatever you want. Once, tap your knees. Two, stand up. Three times, do whatever you want. Okay? I know this is a lot of movement. So we're going to start. So if I tap you once, I'm going to repeat the rules. Tap your knees. If I tap you twice, stand up. If I tap you three times, do whatever you want. If I tap you once, tap your knees. If I tap you twice, stand up. If I tap you three times, do whatever you want. If I tap you once, tap your knees. If I tap you twice, stand up. If I tap you three times, do whatever you want. If I tap you once, tap your knees. If I tap you three times, do whatever you want. If I tap you twice, stand up. Tap you three times, do whatever you want. If I tap you once, tap your knees. If I tap you twice, stand up. If I tap you three times, do whatever you want.
We stop for 2 hours, stop for 3 hours, we have been ready. in a sense, I was given this. Did you pull it to her?
Well, yeah. This is a defenseless swapper. Jay, they can't defend itself.
I don't mean anything by it.
It's just less for less. Just give me my burger, man. What's going on in here?
What?
Inherently about injustice and are inherently unkind.
encourage us to not be kind when we see unkindness. And in 2010, I went to the rally to restore sanity in Washington, D.C. that Stephen Colbert and John Stewart put on. And these are some of the signs that we took pictures of that day, which I think are funny and represents how we can protest for a kinder society. It's not us versus them, because we're all us. And I'm calmer than you are. And I'm so angry I made a sign. I love being right so much, I changed my mind when I'm wrong. This is a good sign. I'm afraid of people who carry signs at rallies. And what do we want? Moderation. When do we want it? Every single time. And I love this kid. Boys, there was another child that they were pushing a stroller, and his sign said, I was told there'd be candy. Pretty cute. And then I love, these are two Catholic priests down with this sort of thing, and the other one says, careful now. And he says, may I please interject? And then I just added this one for fun. What do we want? Time travel. When do we want it? Well, it's irrelevant. So humor could be used as well to disrupt when we see acts of certainly unkindness when we're uncomfortable. I use humor. But we have to use the third order of social movements, and when we challenge for change, we have to have meaningful participation. And the neighbor to neighbor is a start of organizing, or not just a start, but certainly the middle part of organizing for change. But we all have to include ourselves in organizations that are inherently about change. And organizing is really important. It's the third prong to advocate for kindness at the institutional level so that our policies have to reflect justice. We have to ask questions about why our minimum wage is not a living wage, why our CEOs are making 383 times more than their average worker today, more than they've ever made before. These are really hard questions. And when we look at these questions, we're going to ask pretty important questions about why some of us in society feel the American dream is gone. And that's part of advocating for justice and kindness as well. And for those of us who are too young to remember the Cold War, calling someone a communist meant they were unpatriotic. Today we might just say you're unpatriotic. But Dom Helder Camara said, when I give food to the poor, they call me a saint. When I ask why the poor have no food, they call me unpatriotic. So we're going to ask the hard questions today. And I want to remind us that sometimes we can say kindness with charity. And having been a charity case before, I know what it feels like to be the recipient of charity. You wish you didn't have to be that person. You're thankful for it and for the kindness. But part of being a charity case isn't very positive. So today we're going to ask questions about why we need charity as acts of kindness, and remember that charity is no substitute for justice withheld, said St. Thomas Aquinas. So this is just the beginning. I was going to say this is the end of my talk, but really it's just the beginning. Now we're going to get into our breakout sessions and really talk about